name is Lisa Mahadi. I am one of three uniform coordinators for the Tacuma District. I am also the deputy director for the Tacuma Pathfinder Club. Two facts about me are, one, I love children and feel quite comfortable around them. Adults love to speak to me. Perhaps they think I'm a good listener. Today, we are going to speak about Moses. And our scripture reading is taken from Exodus chapter 3, verses 11 to 12. And Moses said unto God, Who am I that I should go unto Pharaoh, and that I should bring forth the children of Israel out of Egypt? And he said, Certainly I will be with thee, and this shall be a token unto thee, that I have sent thee. When thou hast brought thee forth from the out of Egypt, ye shall serve thee upon this mountain. Moses, a compelling figure in the Bible, because he possesses obvious human faults, and yet he was still chosen by God. He was passionate and impulsive like most of us. We sometimes make excuses when we are asked to do things outside our comfort zone. I, for one, am guilty of this. I can totally relate to Moses quite well. When I was asked to make this video, I was ready with my excuses. I don't know yet. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to do. Can you ask someone else? But what did Moses do? After he made his excuses, God gave him the reassurance that he would be with him, and Moses followed God's instruction. Moses was great in words and deeds. His example teaches us to have faith in God's word and that he will be with us. God knew that Moses had the potential to do the task, and that is why he chose him. When God tasked Moses with leading the Israelites out of slavery into the promised land, Moses exercised a great amount of faith as he approached Pharaoh on 10 different occasions. Moses can be considered a hero because he was a leader who inspired others to imagine a new future. He stood up to the Pharaoh and led his people from a state of bondage to a new destiny. His attitude teaches us to act when God whispers in our ear or speaks to us from a burning bush. Three lessons we can learn from Moses. A privileged childhood does not guarantee a good life. We learn our greatest lesson when life is the hardest. All experiences, good or bad, eventually work for the greater good. When we are asked to do something for the Lord, because we have the example set by Moses, we can forego the excuses and say, Yes, I will go. This is because we know that the Holy Spirit will be right there. We know going along with us, providing us with all the courage that we need to carry out our mission. Thank you for listening. Lord, help us to have the courage to go when you say to go, and to answer, Yes, I will go, when our names are called. Amen.